Hello, 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 guys. Happy Make It Yourself Monday. We're making beauty ice cube thingies because it's fun and because they're awesome. So, all right, I told y'all last week that I went to the Young Living Beauty School and we learned all about beauty regimens and cleansers and all that stuff. Well, they were talking about, they gave us this printout that had, it showed all these different actresses and models and stuff that they splash their face with ice water. And they take, as you're hopping on, say hi to me. Hey, guys. And they would take ice cube baths and all these things. Hey, Angela. I can't wait to hear all about your trip. I see lots of you hopping on. Say hi to me. So I was reading about it and they, you know, I was like, why would someone put ice cubes on their face or splash their face with ice water? Hey, Marcy Drake, not the replay. Yay. Hashtag not on the replay. Yeah, you're on live. And so I looked it up. Aw, thank you. Thank you. I looked it up. I was like, why would someone do that to their skin? Why would you put yourself through the torture of ice water on your face? So I did some research and I looked it up and I'm going to share with you guys a few reasons why you would want to do this. And then I'm going to show you how to make it. Look how beautiful these are. Let's see if I can, it's cold. So let me see if I can hold it up. It's a diamond. I found a diamond shaped tray thing. So I'm going to show you how to make it. But let me tell you why you would want to make these. Yeah, burr, it's gold. All right. So when you rub ice on your face, it's really refreshing because our skin goes through so much. So what it does is it helps with blood circulation, and I have cheat notes here because I couldn't memorize all this fast enough. It makes your skin look radiant. So let me read you a couple things. Key to glowing skin. So this is talking about using these ice cube beauty thingies on your face. All right, it says it improves blood circulation to your skin and makes it bright. So applying ice to your face constricts the blood vessels, which initially lowers the blood flow to the skin. But to balance that, what your body does is it starts circulating the blood to your face, which makes it lively and radiant. And so it restricts the blood flow, and then your body starts like pumping it harder, and so that gives you the radiant skin. All right, it enhances product absorption. What I was doing before I researched this, because I used it for a few days to see what it was going to do to my skin before I even looked up what it's supposed to do to my skin. So I love beauty things. Me too. All right, I'm going to try not to get distracted. I'm not going to read your comments, but I'll come back and talk to you later afterwards. Otherwise, we'll be on here all day because I love you guys and I just want to talk to you. So, all right. I was doing the ice. I would wash my face, tone it, then do the ice, and then do the moisturizer. But what this says is you do your moisturizer and then you do the ice, because when you put the ice on your skin, it constricts the capillaries on your face and creates a pooling effect on your skin, which in turn helps to better absorb the products. So you do your moisturizer, then you rub the ice on it. It helps eliminate dark circles. It says if you take rose water, which I showed you guys how to make rose water a while back ago, and some of the videos resurfaced recently. So it's so super easy. I forgot to put the hashtag on here, but I'm going to come back and put hashtag Make It Yourself Monday. And if you click on that, you're going to get a list of all my Make It Yourself Mondays. And you'll see, if you scroll down the list a little bit, you'll see how to make rose water. So it says if you use rose water and add cucumber juice to it and freeze that, then you can use that for dark circles, which I haven't done that yet. So that's something I want to do because that's something that I do get. I get puffy eyes and I get dark circles really easy. So I'm going to try that. So I want you to look that up when I do the hashtag after this. It calms and soothes acne on your face. So when I eat certain eggs, my skin breaks out really bad. It has to be a very certain egg or I'm a mess. Like you can see my skin's a little bit broke out right now. So it says it'll help minimize the oil production in your skin, which helps with the acne. It also works well in the healing and the swelling of it. So it helps take down that swelling, which will help it heal faster. We already talked about swollen under eye bags. It says that excessive fluid accumulation under your eyes can be treated with ice cubes. And it says move it in a circular motion, starting in the inner corner of your eye and move out. So you're pushing all that out with the ice and move it up towards your eyebrows, it says. And that helps reduce the swelling. And then you all know it helps to close your pores. I found that out immediately. Like the very first time I used the ice cubes, and there's actually a recipe. I'm gonna tell you what I put in mine. But the first time I used the ice cubes, I noticed immediately, like my skin looked so much smoother. It says it makes your foundation look flawless. So I'm sure that's because your skin is smoother and your pores are closed. So if you do the ice before your foundation, it's gonna give you a flawless look, and it helps it to stay on longer, it says. Reduces the appearance of wrinkles. This one, Kim, good pastor, you don't have bad pores. You have beautiful skin. So let's see. It controls wrinkles and the signs of aging. Not only helps in reducing the existing ones, but also prevents the formation of new ones. So I think that would take using it for a while before you would see those results. But I did notice that my skin did have a smoother, softer look. And then a few more quick things. It'll soften your lips. When your lips are chapped and swollen, you can rub it on your lips. Easy remedy for heat rashes, reduces sunburns, gives you an oil-free look. So just the ice alone does all kinds of stuff. And you can look it up. You can use green tea. You can use aloe vera. You can do the cucumber. Ice cube trays, it says cinnamon. You can do cinnamon, rose water, rosehip oil. Like, you can use so many things in these. I just used my, these are already melting. I used my filtered water because you want to use the cleanest water that you can get your hands on. If you're just using tap water, then you want to boil that first if you can, and then let that cool down. So here's what I did. I have this really cute little tray. It's actually diamonds. Isn't they cute? And they turn out and they look like this. And so I put in rose, like the dried rose petals first. So I put those in there first. Hey everybody, hey guys, as you're hopping on, thanks for saying hi to me. I put the rose petals in there first. Then I put one drop of geranium in each one. And so my thinking was, because I did a couple of them and I went ahead and did the rose petals and then the water and then the oil. And I thought, well, the oil's just gonna kind of sit in one spot. I want it to disperse out. So I put in the rose petals, put the drop of oil on top of that, and let that soak in. So these ones I did geranium and lavender. Another few good ones would be frankincense. You could do rose, and I thought about doing rose since I'm using rose petals. And I thought, 1, 2, 3, 4, I thought, man, that's 8 drops of rose. I'm not willing to do that. So if I did want to do rose, what I would do is mix a couple of drops in the water and then pour the water in, so I'm not doing 8 drops of rose, because y'all know rose goes a long, long way. Roman chamomile will be another good one. So put your petals in there, put your oils on top, and then use something that has a what would that be called, like a pour spout thing, because if not, if you want to pour it really, really slow, which I found out, if you pour it too fast, everything's just going to come out of the top and you're going to waste the oils that you put in there. So pour it really slow, just pour it barely to the top, and that's all you do, and then you freeze it. So experiment with these and make them fun. Do your cucumber juice and your aloe vera, make the rose water. Go back and find my video on rose water. And then you just rub it on your face. I have makeup on, so I'm not gonna do it this time. But I will tell you, have a towel ready, because it'll run down your arm and drip off your face. So, but it actually does feel really good. And it smells so good. It makes your hands smell good and everything. So I want you to try that and let me know. I saw a couple of you on here say that you do splash your face with cold water. So you guys already are ahead of the game. You know that it does good things. So thanks for hopping on, guys. Oh, and what are you diffusing? What are you diffusing? I'm diffusing Palo Santo because it's free. Is it free this month? I think it's one of the free oils. I just lost my train of thought. And so I've been really studying about Palo Santo and how it helps with emotional blocks and things like that and getting rid of negative energy. And so I'm really diffusing that. So you guys, tell me, what are you diffusing today? And thanks for watching, and I love you guys, and I'll see you back again next Monday. Orange and Thieves, yes. Especially where it's been raining, I feel like my house is feeling icky right now, so Thieves would be great to diffuse right now. All right, I'm gonna come back and answer all these. I love you guys.